Greetings, Aquarius. Welcome to your horoscope. What we've got is Neptune in the first house. It's pretty close to the second house, though. So it's, in one way, we would say in the first house that we're getting in touch with what our spirituality is and what our illusions are. And by the time it's getting to the second house, it's like, wow, I want to have a spiritual talisman. I want to have something like a quartz crystal or a rabbit's foot or a four-leaf clover or whatever it is, an eagle feather, whatever it is that gives you the sense like I've got something going on that's good. Your Saturn ruled sign, Saturn's in your ninth house, but getting closer to your midheaven, getting closer to that leadership position. And I'd say you're graduating from something. You're getting ready to get out of something so you can move into something even better. You know, and sometimes it's uncomfortable taking off the old comfortable set of clothes and putting on something new that needs to be broken in. And it's all fresh. You know. But you got some really good support from your family, from your ancestors, with Jupiter in Taurus, down there in the fourth house. Mars in the eighth emphasizes that transformation. Uranus in the third house is like, I've got something inspiring to talk about and to write about. And ultimately, this full moon in Gemini is going to open up your heart. You know, if you feel like you've been stuck, I'd go out socializing on the full moon if I were you. Because you'll probably meet somebody, at least a friend, if nothing else. And it's going to open your heart and make you feel good. Because I know you, Aquarius, you're not obsessed with the normal things that people are obsessed with. You're obsessed with really peculiar little things. But it's okay, we love you. You give us so much love.